She's Australia's favourite fiction writer. Di Morrissey first won our hearts in the 80s when she formed the original lineup on Good Morning Australia with Gordon Elliott and Kerry-Anne Kennelly. Then almost a decade later, she departed TV to write her very first novel.
Flash forward to 2022 and the best-selling author is taking a trip back to where it all began with her latest offering, The Night Tide. Gives me great pleasure to announce that Di Morrissey is joining us on the couch. Di, this is an absolute honour.
Oh, thank you both. It's so nice to still even know some of the crew still.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Great.
You know them by name.
No.
You know them by name. Herman, yeah, gave Herman a big hug on the way in.
They were the days, as they say.
When you look back at those flashbacks to Good Morning Australia, you know, were they kind of the good old days? You look back at those as the good old days?
Oh, people said Good Morning television would never work. But I'd lived in America and I loved Good Morning America, so I knew it was a no-brainer. And, you know, here we are still. Morning television is just the best.
And you were doing TV before Good Morning Australia. You had quite a life
well,
already.
Oh, well, I as a teenager, when I was at school, I used to be on Bandstand with Brian Henderson. I did the commercials. Oh, my God, what have you got there?
Fantastic.
Those are rare, because Channel 10... They took a whole bunch of tapes, the old videotapes of all the shows, and then went to the tip when they moved. Terrible.
Oh, this is terrible, yeah.
All those archives.
Oh, dear. Yeah. So I was the entertainment reporter, so, you know, and I thought this would be a great job because it was, I'd get in there at 3 a.m. and I'd go home at 10 a.m. Mm. and write my book. But because I was doing entertainment, I had to go and see movies and talk to people, and I'd get home at 10 o'clock at night and then I had to be at Ride at 3 a.m.
Oh, burning the candle.
You know
burning
about those days.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, but you're still entertaining us now. You grew up in Pittwater on Sydney's Northern Peninsula, and that's the inspiration behind this book you've got here. Why did you want to return home in your new book?
Well, it's the wretched COVID. I mean, my books are all inspired by an Australian landscape, so I always go to the place and research and write about it. Iconic places like beautiful Pittwater that we see here. But I couldn't go anywhere with COVID. Mm. So I thought, what's a place that is enmeshed in my heart and soul that I know really well? And so I decided to go back and write about a fictional place where I first went to Pittwater when I was 5 and then we left when I was a young teenager because my father and my baby brother drowned there. Aww. And that totally, from being the most idyllic place, it became such a sad place. And that's me on the veranda of Dorothea McKellar's house, who wrote My Country. I love a sunburnt country. And Dorothea was the one, when I was a little girl, I told her that we were very poor and I didn't have a lot of books, so I made up my own stories. And she said, when you grow up, you must put them in a book one day for other people to enjoy. And at 7, I went, what a great idea.
Wow, yeah.
It took a while.
Pittwater is a stunningly beautiful place.
Yeah.
And you're writing about tragedy. Are you expressing it's a fiction.
No, it's more of a mystery. Mm. It's a young man who leaves politics and house sits in a boat shed, which now today would be worth about $5 million.
Yes,
but however, and he's house sits in a boat shed. And he meets the community and he... because it's a very much a community, because you have to get a boat to get over there, and discovers that there's a couple that have a father and a husband who just... A lovely man, a school teacher, good man, everybody loved him, just didn't come home one night 25 years ago and no one ever knew what happened. Now, I thought that could sound a long stretch. Mm. It just sort of came into my head and I had no idea when I started the book how it was going to end, but never mind about that. I'm not going to tell you. But the thing was, I then started to notice on radio and TV people being interviewed. This is not uncommon.
Yeah.
Where
yeah.
people just, well, you know, I mean, crime figures maybe, but good people disappear. It's extraordinary how many. So, you know, so anyway, the book is a mystery, but it's also an homage to a very, very extraordinary Australian landscape.
Is there some of your Hawaii Five-O storylines coming into play here? You were on Hawaii Five-O.
I'm running a script somewhere.
Oh, Hawaii Five-O. Yeah, dear old Jack Lord, yeah. I wish he was a fabulous painter. He used to paint on the side of the set on Hawaii Five-O. And to this day, I wish I'd bought one of his paintings. But that was a very special era. And I worked in television. I had a morning show in in KGMB in Honolulu for 2 years, which was fun. You get to meet all kinds of people, don't you?
Yeah, oh, well, and we do too, yeah.
And you, in London, you went to a garden party with the Queen.
I did, I must say. I never met the Queen. I admire her enormously. I just think she has a most terrific sense of humour, which occasionally you hear people tell you stories, like Kevin Rudd's story the other day that he talked about her dog. She sounds like she would have been jolly good fun, as well as being an extraordinary woman. But I was woman's editor of the Daily Mail, and we used to have to cover things like garden parties, but I never did get to meet her. I was somehow or other in the Australian back row.
Yeah,
but you are, said, yeah. You are also an extraordinary woman and jolly good fun.
And we're delighted to get the chance to meet you. You're putting a book out every year. This one, I heard, is the best one yet. The Night Tide hits all great bookstores today. Di Morrissey, thank you so much for joining us today.
Pleasure, really Tristan.
It's been our pleasure.
Thank you, Nara.
It really has.